Good morning, students. I hope you all are fine. So let's begin with our English language, Standard 7, Part 2, Chapter 25. That is the uses of present and past tense. Students, in this slide, we'll read about or study about past tense. So before going into the past tense, children, let me recall what we have done in our previous class. Children, do you remember that I have taught you tenses which are of three types, that is present tense, past tense and future tense, and again that subdivision chart also I have provided you and asked you to write in your notebooks, and I hope so you all must have written. Children, in present tense, past tense and future tense, we all have the subdivision as 4-4 each. So here we are again going to talk about the four past tense forms. That is, past tense is divided into four forms. That is, simple past tense, or we also say past indefinite tense. Number two, past continuous tense, which we also say as past progressive tense. And number three, past perfect. Number four, past perfect continuous tense. So these are the four tenses which we need to keep in our mind. Before going into the tenses, children, I would like to ask you to memorize it perfectly. In this slide, students will understand how the subdivision of past tense, that is simple past tense, is used and when to use it. Simple past tense, the very first point we see, it actually indicates an action which completed in the past, whatever you have finished in the past. That is, for example, we'll make it more clear. She left school last year. Here I have underlined left, which means that is the past tense. We are not using the verb in present tense. Remember, children, verb denotes the tense. So here in the second example we see that it is written he wrote a letter, and in bracket I have written V2, means verb second form is used. That is, he wrote a letter. Here first form of verb is write, the second form is wrote. So we are using wrote. So always remember, V2 will be used over here. And it is also used with adverb. Sometimes with adverbs also it is used. Now in second part we see, sometimes this tense is used without an adverb of time. Where time is not mentioned, there also we use. For example, I didn't sleep well. Now, we of course know when, last night. So the adverb of time is missing, but still we know that they are talking about last night. So here, I didn't sleep well. So this example also made us clear that tense is used without an adverb of time. In the third point we see, it is also used for past habits. I remember, children, in the present tense, simple present tense also, I have asked you that any regular habit or routine, when it shows, we have to use that. So same here also it goes with it, but remember, children, that was present and this is past. So past plus ED, we mostly, generally we notice that these forms are used mostly in simple past or past tense, you can say. For example, she always used to talk. So this is showing the habit of a person by adding always to it, that person or that girl, she always used to talk. She never used to be quiet in the class. So that was her habit they are talking about. And second also point we'll see and make it clear. He studied many hours every day. He studied, and we are talking about the past habit that a person, that a man or that a boy used to do that, he used to study many hours every day. So that was his habit to do. Here children, you have to note one thing, that in positive sentence we use we to, whereas in interrogative or negative sentence we use we one. How? I will make you clear with the help of an example. For example, if I consider positive sentence, if I say I woke up at 6 o'clock today. So children, this is a positive sentence where you can notice I said I woke up. Woke means it is verb second form. So here we are using, in positive sentence we are using verb second form. Whereas now interrogative and negative, I am going to give the example. If I am giving if I say he did not come yesterday. So here I said he did not come. I did not say came. I said come. So here we notice that with the usage of did, what we are using? Verbs first form. With the usage of did, what do we use? Verbs first form. Always remember, whenever did will come with did, we'll use verb 1. And same here with interrogative, that is question mark. Questions like did you go there yesterday? So here again I have used go. I did not say went. So here V1 form I have used with did again. Whether did is in front or at the back, but we have to notice that thing, that wherever you get did, wherever you get did, you, what you will write over there? You will write over there V1, that is verb first form. So you have to remember these points carefully in your mind. Moving further to the slide children, we can see that we have come to the second sub point of past tense, that is past continuous tense. Here past continuous tense is used for an action going on at some time in the past, means that action was continued in the past. So that continuous movement or action was there at some point in the past or in some time in the past. Now here we can also see the helping verbs which are used under this past continuous tense are was / were plus V1, that is verbs first form plus ing. So here children, where do we use was and where do we use were? So here first person, remember was is always used with first person singular. I, he, she, it. We always use was with these nouns or subjects. Whereas this where we use with the second person plural, that is you, we, they. So I hope this usage of was and were is clear. That is, I always, we can use I was studying, because I also mentioned over here, I have written here V1 plus ing. So I was studying that day. So here I am using I with the usage of was plus V1, that is study, plus ing form. So here we can come to know that that is a past continuous tense I am talking about. Here also with the usage of you can do the same thing, like you were dancing that day. So here I am using you plus were plus verbs first form dance plus ing. So now let's look one more example, one or two more example, that is it was getting darker. So here I am using was with it and using the verbs first form, that is get plus ing, getting. So getting darker, that time they are talking about, the action was going on sometime in the past, that we are saying as it was getting darker. So the light went out while I was reading. So at that point of time, that somewhere in the past when I was reading, the light went out. Okay, children, one more point we need to remember in this, that is, this tense is also used with always, continually, etc. for habits in the past. Now, children, whatever habits also are there, they should be in ing forms, like I have given here. He was always grumbling. Always means he was, means is in the past tense we are using, that is a helping verb, was. He was, what he was doing always, every time, that was his habit of what? Grumbling, of always grumbling. Like, what is grumbling? Grumbling means always you are dissatisfied with something. You are not satisfied. When it is raining, then also you are grumbling. When it's bright, hot day, then also you are grumbling. So grumbling means that. So it has become his habit to grumble. Okay. Here we see the third form of past tense, that is past perfect tense. Now, what do we learn in past perfect tense? Where do we use it? Past perfect tense is actually describes an action which completed before a certain moment in the past. An action which completed before a certain moment in the past, before a certain time in the past, that action has been completed. So here we can see we use had plus V3 form. Had plus V3 form means, here the usage of verb's third form is there. For example, if we say, I had written. So, I explained you earlier also, write, wrote, written. So, verb's third form is written. So, here we are using written. V2, V1. Do not use over here. So, we are going to use in the past perfect tense verb third form. That is, I had written a letter. So, now one more thing which we need to keep in our mind is, when two actions happened in the past, suppose two actions are there in the past, it may be necessary to show which action happened earlier. Now, it can also happen that you have to show that which action happened earlier, which one you want to say before. So, that also you need to keep in mind how you have to say. For example, I had done. Remember, children, had plus verb third form. So, I had done my exercise when? When Hari came to see me. Actually, Hari came to see me, but before that I am describing the action which already happened. That is, when Hari came to see me, I had already done my exercise. So, I first hand prefer to say, I had done my exercise when Hari came to see me. So, this action was already done. That is, I had done my exercise. And then who appeared? Hari appeared for seeing him. So, this you need to keep in mind, that when two actions are there in the past, it may be necessary to show which action happened earlier. Okay? So, this is how we use past perfect tense. In this slide, we'll see the sub-point of past tense, that is the fourth point, the past perfect continuous tense. So, in past perfect continuous tense, children, we'll see when to use it. Past perfect continuous tense actually is used for an action that began somewhere in the past and it continued up to that time. Now, how we will understand this? First of all, the usage of had, that is in the second point we look into, had plus been plus verb's first form plus ing plus since for whatever is given. So, for example, if I say she, we have to use had plus been plus verb's first form, that is work, plus ing. So, she had been working as a chef before she became an actor. means before the time when she became an actor, what she was doing? She was working as a chef. So here we see that it is an action that began in the past and it continued up to that time. So this is past perfect continuous tense. So children, we have learned all the four tenses, that is the sub-tenses of past tense. That is past simple or past indefinite tense, past continuous or past progressive tense, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. Before starting with this slide, I would just like to recall what we have learned in this entire exercise is about past and present tense. That is, present tense and past tense both have four for each sub points, and in present tense the sub points were simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense, present perfect continuous tense. And whereas in past tense, today we have learnt simple past tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. Now children, keeping those points into mind, let us solve this exercise in composition 46, which you have to do in your notebooks given in page number 78 in your grammar book. So choose the correct verb form from those in bracket. Here in the bracket, these verbs are given. We have to choose the correct one and fill it in the blanks. So first is the earth dash round the sun. So of course this is an universal truth. So here we will put into simple present tense. So it will become move, moves or moved. So of course the answer will be move. So I have underlined over here. You can go through the underlined words which are your answers. Second sentence we see is, my friends dashed the Prime Minister yesterday. See, have seen, saw. So the answer will be saw. Number 3, I dash him only one letter up to now. Sent, have sent or sent. So have sent is the answer. Number 4, she dash worried about something. Looking. So looks will be the answer. Number 5, it started to rain while we dashed tennis. Are playing, were playing, had played. So were playing is the answer. Children, note that your homework is all the remaining sentences from 6 to 15 must be done in your classwork copy and it will be discussed in the next class.